Okay. Mike, can you hear me? Hello, good afternoon, and welcome to today's matchup against the Penfield Patriots and the Coastal Harbor Seahawks. Now I'll introduce Penfield's starting lineup. Number 15, Emma Alexander. Number 19, Jenna Capozzi. Number 8, Riley Corcoran. Number 18, Avery Fordham. Number 0, Karis Hand. Number 3, Emerson Mathis. Number 12, Madeline Obstarkson. Number 7, Aaliyah Petrie. Number 17, Whitney Reynolds. Number 9, Peyton Rothfuss. Number 21, Regan Serkey. And number 2, Allison Wells. Number 8, Kelly Callaghan. Number 3, Michelle Coles. Number 19, Jenna Kessler. Number 2, Sienna Cope. Number 7, Rachel Louie. Number 27, Gianna Marino. Number 20, Ryan Reynolds. Number 30, Maya Soskin. Number 6, Zoe Soskin. Number 15, Maggie Spear. And number 14, Ruby Spielberger. Now please rise if able.
Joshua, joining alongside me is Coach Wink. Coach Wink, how are we doing here this afternoon?
Oh, we're doing awesome, buddy. Very excited to see the Penfield Patriots from the Rochester area going up against the Cold Spring Harbor Seahawks based in Suffolk County, Long Island.
Yeah, and this should be a good one. Coming a day late because of the weather, but it'll be worth it for sure. Glad that we're getting this matchup going here. Penfield making the trip from Rochester down here to Long Island, where they'll be playing a couple games. So
yes,
getting set to play Cold Spring Harbor, and then tomorrow they'll be taking on Northport.
Yeah, it's ironic too, their boys team is playing West Islip tonight.
Yeah,
I was just talking to one of the moms, and she's heading over there after this game, and West Islip is playing the Penfield Patriot boys. So good for Penfield getting out there to play some talented teams from Long Island, and I'm sure Cold Spring Harbor is excited to play a talented team from the Rochester area.
And so both teams coming into this matchup. This is game number 3 for both teams. So for Penfield, they come in at 1-1. A loss to Victor, but a win against Bethlehem. And Cold Spring Harbor, they come into this matchup 2-0, picking up wins against Farmingdale and Port Washington.
Yeah, the Port Washington game was a little close for comfort from what I heard. Triple overtime?
Yeah, that one definitely had the excitement and definitely a lot of buildup and a triple OT win for Cold Spring Harbor. As we're just about set for the opening draw here.
Yeah, looks like the girls are about to get out there and get after it. It's looking to me like the sun's trying to break out.
Yeah, we could use it for sure. After the weather we've had here the last day and a half.
Oh my God, I need Noah's Ark. I felt like we were going to be looking for two different animals, two different turtles. And I saw a turtle crossing, by the way, on my way to our game the other day. I was like, I've never seen a turtle crossing sign.
How about that?
Yeah, I guess there's some turtles in the Northport area.
So on the opening draw here, it'll be Ryan Reynolds for Cold Spring Harbor up against Peyton Rothfuss for Penfield. And this one is underway. And possession going to Penfield to start this one. Coming up with possession is Jenna Capozzi. And so it's the Patriots with the game's first possession.
I like the unis. I like both teams' unis. They look sharp.
Yeah, both teams looking fly in these unis. I do like the black for Penfield. It's a nice look. Cold Spring Harbor, of course, in the home whites. And possession with Peyton Rothfuss.
They know to triple team her. Watch out for that young lady. Oh, good luck. Here's the finish. Save.
By Maya Soskin. And the second shot off the pipe. And this one is going to stay with Penfield. So drawing the contact, looks like that is Emma Alexander. So Alexander with a chance for the shot. Oh. And that one off the pipe as well. And into the stick of Jenna Capozzi.
Goal!
And there's the goal for Penfield, as they had a number of chances to get on the board. And they do on the goal there. Avery Fordham.
Number 18, right? That was from number 3?
That's correct.
Emerson Mathis. That was just as they drew it up, it looked like. A couple pipes. Then they find the back of the net. Penfield takes the 1-0 lead. Tough to see the scoreboard. I'll have to look at our scoreboard.
Don't worry, I'll help you out.
Our scoreboard. Sponsored by Total Coach. Great job by the LI Sports Network putting together this telecast for us. We certainly appreciate it.
So back to the draw circle. Once again, Rothfuss against Reynolds. And Rothfuss winning that one to herself. So another possession for Penfield. And it looks like right away, Peyton Rothfuss drawing the shooting space. Rothfuss, that shot is going to be Penfield's second goal of the game.
Peyton Rothfuss is one of the top 2026s in the country. For those that don't know about her game, you'll be seeing it today. She splits the uprights right here. Let's see the replay on this play. She found the bottom corner.
So quickly. Just under a minute, 40 seconds into this one, and Penfield with the 2-0 lead.
This is where you see how critical the draw is. Two possessions, two goals.
Yeah, so far Penfield winning that battle on the draw circle. And this possession will go to Cold Spring Harbor, ending up in the stick of Ruby Spielberger. So this will be the first offensive possession for the Seahawks as they look to get on the board. So possession with Jenna Kessler. Now they give it to Sienna Koch, and now that's Kelly Callahan. The CSH looks to move the rock. And it's Amelia Bentley working that one back up top to Spielberger. Oh, and a tough pass there. That one looks like it's going to trickle out of bounds. So that's going to be a turnover by CSH, giving this one back to Penfield as they look to clear up the field. So with possession is Allison Wells. And she works that up to Rothfuss. So Penfield looking to take early control in this game.
I'm seeing the sunshine out there.
Yeah, bring on the sun, please.
It's coming. It's coming. Maryland! The flowers are going to be beautiful this spring with all the rain we've had. Posey, good luck.
Slip inside. Good defense still by Penfield, but Rothfuss, she gets the rock and she scores. So that's her second of the game, and that's going to give Penfield the early 3-0 lead.
You see Capozzi drawing, great look. That looks like that was to Avery Fordham, right? I think that was 18, right? Left-handed feet. She splits it.
Wow, what a shot there by Rothfuss.
I think we're one goal away from a timeout for Coach Castellan.
Yeah, you might be right here, because so far the momentum solely with Penfield. And that's another win on the draw. That one won by Rothfuss.
It's 3-1 so far, Penfield, as far as draws.
Yeah, and we talk about it all the time. That typically, that percentage of wins on the draw circle is oftentimes the difference in the game. Roth is looking inside there. Penfield going to pull it back out.
Looks like Cold Spring Arbor's in a backer zone. Trying to see, is that Soskin? It's the six. Yeah, it's Zoe Soskin. Oh, nice save.
Oh, how about that save by Soskin? Maya Soskin, the junior, committed to Florida. Of course, one of the top goalies on the island, in the state, in the country.
Yeah, that's a big save. Let's see if that helps the momentum for the Seahawks.
Yeah, a lot of times you see a big save like that kind of get the energy up, get the morale up, and you can turn a great save like that into a goal on the other end. So Reynolds keeps possession and gets that up to Kessler. And that one deflected.
It's a great ride. Penfield had a really nice ride. So this is where the shot clock will. They'd probably be down about 30 seconds if they had a shot clock.
So now that's Callahan. Callahan looks like she's going to draw the contact. And so Cold Spring Harbor, they're going to have their first opportunity here to get on the board.
Yeah, very curious to see how. This goalie has one of the greatest names, Karis Hand. Let's see what kind of hand she has.
Shot.
Nice shot by Callahan.
Callahan getting Cold Spring on the board. Just what they needed.
They're putting the ball in the right spot. All the shooters so far are picking corners. I mean, Rothfuss picked two bottom corners. It looks like Callahan. That's a tough save for a lefty off the... jumps at it, though. She looks pretty athletic in there.
Yeah, and Karis Hand, just a freshman. So.
Wow.
Look out for her.
Yeah.
This year and the next three.
It is a very young team. And when I looked at it, they got six of their starters are freshmen and sophomores. So they got 2 and 3 years together. It's awesome.
Yeah, and that's definitely one of the benefits when. As Rothfuss once again coming up with possession for Penfield, but that's certainly a benefit if you're a coach, even though you're a young team, knowing that you're going to have a lot of your core for the next handful of years, like that just adds experience over the course of time, and that's something that can definitely play to their advantage as these girls enter that upperclassman age coming up.
Oh, good try by Louis.
Yeah, Louis there looking for the pickoff. But instead, this one stays with Penfield. And so Whitney Reynolds, she draws the shooting space. Looking to give Penfield a 4-1 lead. Oh, Soskin. What a save. So Cold Spring Harbor now looking to take that save and go the other way. Here comes Rachel Louie. So Louie, nice job clearing there for CSH. And the ball back on the offensive side of the field for the Seahawks. So possession now with Maggie Spear. Oh, and she gets checked. And Penfield coming up with that one, Jenna Capozzi. And Penfield looks to take the other way. Here comes Emma Alexander.
You share the ball real well.
Yeah, Penfield doing a really good job of moving the ball, sharing the rock. And they've done a good job here of being able to draw a number of shooting space calls.
Oh,
Maya Soskin.
She's making the difference right now. This could be a 6-1 game.
Big time. So here comes Colton Harbor. It's Jenna Kessler. Yep, Riley Miller, number 10. Now possession with Amelia Bentley as she gives back to Spear. Now back to Bentley.
She got her hands for a goal. Great shot, great placement by Bentley. Put it right off her hip. They're putting the ball in the right spot on. I mean, as you can see, two good goaltenders. Soskin making some great saves. That's a Soskin assist. Watch this, watch where she puts the ball. Literally, they say put it off your hip, above your hip, towards the shoulder. Oh, can't place it any better than that.
Great finish there by Bentley. So we have a 3-2 game now. No shortage of goals so far here in the early stages, as we have 4:09 remaining in the first quarter. We're now back at the draw circle. So Rothfuss again for Penfield. Cold Spring Harbor switching it up, going with Bentley. And the win as that one winds up in the stick of Liv Malata, the freshman.
You gotta love her on the draw circle. She's one of their top basketball players here. They went pretty far this year, right? Didn't they play in the county championship?
They were in the Long Island Championship, I believe.
So they won the counties.
Yeah, had a close defeat, I believe, against Kings Park, but I believe this was a historic run for the Lady Seahawks basketball team.
Back in 2005, they went to the semifinals of the States.
Okay.
That's almost 20 years ago. Might have been 04.
How about Penfield now? Looking to push in transition. Oh, ball down. But they do maintain possession.
Oh, she's got space. Soskin.
Looking to get inside and shot. Oh! Unbelievable. Maya Soskin having herself a heck of a first quarter.
They need it. They need it.
Man, she's seen a ton of shots here already in the early stages. And she's come up big time.
Ooh. That was a little high.
So this possession staying with Rachel Louie. And she works that one over to Spielberger, who looks to clear.
Michelle Cole's bringing it up.
So Cold Spring Harbor now, a chance to tie up this game. Now that's Malata.
Good defense by Madeline Oberstar. Oh, I'm going to have to pronounce that name. Starzik.
Oh, Starzik. Oh, that's okay. Reynolds. And it looks like this one's going to stay with Ryan Reynolds. Reynolds, the junior, committed to Maryland.
Yeah, Long Island is Terp land now. They're getting a lot of Long Island stars.
Yeah, they're getting a bunch in the 24 and 25 class.
Yeah, I wanted to give a shout-out to one that got injured in her first game. Lila Ingrilli, unfortunately, went down for the season.
Oh, no.
Yeah, she's a defender for Wantagh. Her sister's at Carolina. She's going to be heading to Terp land in a couple of years. She's texting her pop, and unfortunately, she's going to be out for the year. Here comes Malata.
Oh, nice. That shot is going to tie the game for Amelia Bentley.
Little dip and dunk. Great job. Malata gets it, sees that, gets Bentley open. Now the girl, if you can see the number 7 coming across, which is Petre. She gets her hands free, throws the fake. See the deception with her head?
Yes.
That's what made the goalie kind of dip down. Great job by Amelia Bentley.
So just like that, we have a tie game. 3-3 with 1:20 remaining in the first quarter.
Game of runs.
Yeah, that's exactly what this game is proving to be right now. And it looks like this one's going Penfield's way. So possession will start with Avery Fordham. Serku with the rock.
We're below a minute, Ellis. So it looks like I would think that they're going to hold. Looks like they're getting in a circle formation, which means usually you're going to stall a little bit and work towards that last shot.
Yeah, definitely the right idea here without the shot clock and in a tie game right now. This Coltsman Harbor has the momentum at this point. It's Penfield. They don't want to give them one more possession.
Ooh, that was a nice move.
Yeah, and that shot there.
Freshman.
Shot there by Whitney Reynolds goes high.
Considering how good these kids are at such a young age.
Oh, and ball down.
Turnover. And this 20 one. Seconds. Gotta let the ball do the work. We got a whistle. The clock running. We're looking at 13 seconds. That's going up. Oh, nice throw. She nice throws the ball up. She should get him.
Nice
oh, they got numbers.
The look for Coke. Shot. Goal! Sienna Coke with that goal. And that started on the other end with Rachel Louie.
Yeah.
Getting that one up to Kessler.
Let's see who made that feed.
And then Kessler, as she got that one to
that
Bentley.
Bentley. Great feed.
And Bentley giving to Coke for the finish.
Huge. Unfortunate for Penfield. I thought they were going to wait till about 10 seconds to go before they made their move. Or 15 at least. Kudos to Seahawk defense.
Yeah, that's textbook turning defense to offense. So they have the 4-3 lead now. Coltsman Harbor does, and that will do it for the first quarter. What a first 12 minutes of action here at CSH High School.
Take a little break, and we'll be back for your second quarter.
Last game, they broke records. It was like over 10 million people.
Did you get it?
Yeah. Good timing.
Alright, so we're back here, just about set for quarter number two, and no shortage of action in the first 12 minutes. Cold Spring Harbor getting momentum there after falling behind early, but they now have the 4-3 lead going into the second.
Four-goal run. There was a three-goal run for Benfield and then a four-goal run. Let's see what happens here. Putting Bentley, good move by Coach Castellon, putting Bentley on the draw circle and then putting Mulata. Mulata's got two of them off of Bentley's stick. Olivia Mulata, only a freshman. Bentley's heading to Drexel, right? She's heading to be a Drexel Dragon.
That's correct.
It's a nice little area to go to college. You got Drexel there. You got UPenn there. Nice part of Philadelphia. She'll have a good time at school.
So opening draw of the second quarter is up. And this possession is going to Penfield.
Yep, she's asking for space. Good move by Capozzi. Tells you being coached well. You gotta ask for it. They won't give it to you unless you ask for it, which is silly, you know? But that's the rule.
Yeah, you feel like it's something that should just be given every time.
Because in college, if you don't give them space, it's a penalty.
So Mathis, give that one to Reynolds. Penfield looking to work this one around here. So Rothfuss matched up against Louis. Good defense here by CSH.
Generally, that's their stamp. Daniel always has a good, always coaches defense real well and usually has real good defense. Game didn't start out, but Soskin might have settled them in a little bit. Oh goal!
Wow!
As I open my mouth, bingo!
And Capozzi, she shot that one with some aggression there. What an assertive take there. And that ties this one up at four.
Sincere get to her right. Great job by 17, sealing the other 17. Whitney Reynolds was sealing Mackenzie McGraw, and she couldn't come and help. It was a good play.
So a 4-4 game now. Back at the draw circle. Bentley against Rothfuss. And that one is going to be awarded to Penfield.
Got to start it back at the circle, though. Game's going down to the wire.
Yeah, this could be one of those games. So far, we're one for one. The GC Bayport game.
That was a great game.
Yup. It's a great way to start off the games of the week this season.
We try to pick games that we think are going to be close. You just never know.
So Penfield now looking to reclaim that momentum. After giving up four unanswered to CSH, they've tied it at four now and looking to reclaim the lead.
Looks like they settled in. Yeah, so they called a move and pick on that.
Yep.
Which was exactly the play that they just ran. And they were trying to run it again. It's interesting.
Yeah, and you like the idea because it worked once, so
yeah,
go back to the well.
Yeah, until they cover it.
Yeah, just unable to execute it there. Get this ball down. Up for grabs. And possession will be going right back to Penfield, so another chance here.
Oh, she's got Rothfuss. Smart to pull it out, though. You got a possession. Set up your offense. See if they run it on the opposite side. It's interesting. They don't have any lefties. All the girls are righties. They don't have any lefties on this team.
Yeah, you know, that's one thing. It's tough to overcome that when you don't have a lefty.
But
there's a lot of teams out there that wish they had more.
Yeah, you want the balance. Definitely want the balance in this game.
Lefties are hard to find.
Definitely share the ball, Penfield. It looks like they play very good team offense.
Yeah, and I would say...
Oh, good luck.
Nice look.
Oh!
And it's finished off there on that goal, Emma Alexander.
That came from Whitney Reynolds, I believe. 17, right? Let's see who fed that. You can see it on the Total Coach replay. So pops it up top. Let's see where she's slicing in. Where's Whitney Reynolds coming out? Yep. There she is. Hey, left Whitney. Great vision. That was I right on that?
Yes, Whitney Reynolds on that assist.
Good look. So we're at what, 5-4 now? 5-4 Penfield.
5-4 game. 8:30 to go here in the second quarter.
Beat a dead horse, but that's what just shows you it's all about the draw. I've always said if you can dominate the draw, you're generally going to have a great chance to win.
Yeah, that's really like if anything, you got to have a really great draw specialist to at least give your team a chance to win that possession game.
Yeah, that's why Kayla Gilmore, the Floyd.
I was just thinking that.
Right? She's such a big asset. I mean, we're going to be covering. Aren't we covering a game with her?
Yeah, we got to see her already against Connect Quad, and we'll be seeing them again against Northport.
Yeah, that's
later on this month.
That's a big game. That's a big game for both teams. Floyd just had a big win against Smithtown East. I saw they took it to him.
So Penfield, so far they've been winning those possessions here in the second quarter, and looking to extend their lead.
Posey getting ready to crank one.
And that shot goes wide.
That goes white.
And looks like, yeah, it's going back to Cold Spring. So Rachel Louie there winning the chase. And now Soskin will pick it up. And the Seahawks will look to clear. That's big there.
Ooh.
And Louie taking a ton of contact.
Gotta love the aggressiveness of both teams.
Yeah, both teams really trying to create takeaways with their ride. Nice handle there by Kessler. So CSH able to clear. Now they'll look to come up with that tying goal. So possession with Kelly Callahan.
Oh, good day.
And this one taken away as this one going back to Penfield, trying to keep it in bounds. Oh, and a nice scoop there by Kessler for Cold Spring.
I apologize. We don't have a 24 on our roster. So you can DM us on the Instagram and let us know who number 24 is for Penfield. Just made a great defensive play.
Oh, 24. That would be Olivia Reed.
Oh, you have it. Oh, you know what it is? She's not on I'm looking at the starters. Thank you.
You're welcome.
That was a great play by her. Got to give her a little shout out. I only have the starters page. I got it. When they add people, I got to write them in. I gave my boy Ellis my roster. Since he's the play-by-play boy.
So Penfield, as they look to settle in here, possession with Posey. Oh, nice strip there from behind. Nice job there. As Cold Spring Harbor was looking for the takeaway.
Who's that, Mary Gules? Made that play? 16? Did she get hurt? Oh, boy.
Yeah, Julis with the check, but...
Oh, that's not good.
She's down, and let's hope that she's okay. So we're going to get the coaches and the training staff coming out here to check on her. Hope that she's okay and that it's nothing too serious. So the trainer out there with the golf cart, and hopefully she'll be okay. So we're going to take a quick break as they tend to Julis, and we'll come back shortly. Here, and good news is Mary Julis is standing up, as you can see on the telecast here, and hopefully she's okay. Might not be able to put any pressure on it, but at least she's standing upward. It was a really nice defensive play too, a nice trail check. She's going to get in the cart and head off the field here. So in the second quarter, we have 5:18 remaining. Penfield leading this one 5-4. And possession is going to be going back to Cold Spring Harbor.
They gave it to him. Huh? It's interesting. I was wondering what the call was. Like, did she knock it out of bounds?
Yeah, I believe on that trail check, the ball wound up going out of bounds. And so Cold Spring Harbor back with it. Ryan Reynolds with the rock. So Reynolds getting this one up the field for the Seahawks. And once again, they'll look here to try and tie up this game at 5.
You know, they got to get into their offensive sets and get organized.
So the Seahawks working this one around. Now possession with Bentley as she gives to Reynolds. Now that's Reynolds back with it. And Reynolds, she draws the whistle here for Cold Spring Harbor. So this is going to be a free position for the Maryland commit, Ryan Reynolds. And Reynolds, that shot, that one goes high. But it looks like this one is going to be staying with CSH. And Reynolds, she's going to get another chance here.
A little better angle.
Yeah, better spot here, so easier chance to try and cash in that shot.
Ooh.
That one going wide there. And Penfield closest to it as they reclaim possession. Ball down though and looking to secure possession. This one up for grabs. And coming up with that ground ball is Alexander. And now that's Emerson Mathis giving back to Alexander. As we're approaching 3 minutes remaining here in the second quarter.
Skies are open up. I see blue, Ellis. I haven't seen blue in like a month.
This is a good sign. This is a good omen. Good strip there from behind, but Penfield keeping possession. So Mathis behind the cage with the rock.
You set those free throws up.
Yep, so drawing the whistle there is Whitney Reynolds. And Reynolds, she looks locked and loaded. That shot. Wow. What a shot there on the free position by Whitney Reynolds.
Only a freshman, guys. Only a freshman.
As we take another look at this on our instant replay presented by Total Coach. And I feel like Coach Wink, sometimes when a girl is set up on a free position, just based on their stance, you can kind of see like, okay, this is about to be a missile. this one is coming in with some heat.
Yeah. And the funny thing is, for those of you that are from the Rochester area, the Penfield girls are scoring on one of the top 25 goalies in the country. So, I mean, Soskin usually can come up with those, but when you shoot it in the right spot and at the speed, as you can see, the Penfield girls now have 6.
So back at the draw circle now, the 6-4 lead for Penfield. So Bentley against Rothfuss. And the chase for the ground ball. And that one winds up going to Jenna Capozzi. So another possession for Penfield here. And a chance to retake a 3-goal lead. A tough pass. And this one going back to Cold Spring Harbor on the GV by Mackenzie McGraw. So it could be a big turnover there. Nice handle there by Sienna Koch. Now here comes Cold Spring Harbor. Kelly Callahan now going to look to settle this one down. So now with inside of a minute 20 remaining here, Coach Wink, you holding for potentially the final shot here?
I think I'm just working for a good shot down two. You know, don't force it. Danielle's coach Danielle Castellan's played a lot of players. Give her a lot of credit. Oh, nice defensive play again. That's Olivia again with the second cause turnover. Right?
So, yeah, number 24, Olivia Reed.
Having a day. Two cause turnovers on the last two defensive possessions for them, and now they have an opportunity. Oh, good look by Rothfuss.
And that's Emerson Mathis as she draws the shooting space.
That, see, that's an opportunity where if you have a lefty, they're coming with their stick to the inside, and you have an opportunity to get a shot off. This is a tough angle.
Yeah, this is not the ideal angle here for a shot.
Not unless you put it in your left hand.
Yep.
Yeah, I had a feeling she was going to pull it out.
Yeah, tough angle, and now about 30 seconds here in the quarter. They can essentially hold for that final shot. So they work this back up top. Ball down. But they do maintain possession. Now that's Jenna Capozzi. Inside of 10 seconds here in the quarter. Oh, and that shot.
Oh,
that would have been a highlight reel goal there.
Yeah, that would have made
by Rothfuss if she was able to connect. But that'll take us to halftime. It's Penfield leading this one 6-4. We'll take a brief break and come back shortly with the start of the second half.
Thank you. is growing.
All right, so we're back live here at Cold Spring Harbor High School. Coming up with the start of the third quarter between CSH and Penfield. Penfield leading this one 6-4 as they pitched a shutout in that second quarter.
Yeah, it was great. Great defense. We got to give a little shout out to Olivia. Olivia had two caused turnovers that when CSH got the ball, and those are big. Those are huge in this game.
Yeah, Cold Spring Harbor not too many offensive possessions in that second quarter. So they're going to look to try and win this opening draw of the third year as it's Rothfuss against Bentley. So this one is up. And this one goes to Penfield. Coming up with that one, Avery Fordham. I think so far that's definitely been a difference maker in Penfield having this two-goal lead, doing a really good job on the draw circle.
Yeah, the numbers on the draw is definitely 70 to 80% black.
So a chance now to equal their largest lead of the game. They started off with a 3-0 lead back in the first quarter. On that pass, did not meet its intended target. And coming up with that ground ball was Maggie Spear. So Cold Spring Harbor looking to take advantage of that turnover. So it's Kelly Callahan with possession. Callahan, she's looking for the shot, and she scores. Kelly Callahan, the junior committed to UChicago.
Oh, yeah. This is somebody that's not just good on the field. She's good in the books. Look at the rocker step back. And, nope, I'm going. You got past her. Great play by Kelly. That's a big goal. Draw him within one. Now the CSHC is looking to try to get the draw. The Penfield girls have been dominating that circle.
Yeah, and that's one of those situations where if you're Cold Spring Harbor, you haven't been winning the majority of draws, and yet you're only down a goal here.
Yeah, I like the way they move the ball. This kid, Avery Fordham, has come up with every loose ball. Only a freshman also.
So possession back with Penfield. Looking to answer that Kelly Callahan goal.
Very interesting, Ellis, that they're using, it looks like they're using the gate draw stick because Rothfuss changes the stick after each draw. The girls swear by that stick for draws.
Hey, got to use the gate draw stick for the gate game of the week.
Yeah.
So Capozzi with possession for Penfield. And Capozzi with the blow by and that shot. That one. Like Soskin might have gotten a piece of that one and
hit the pipe.
Off the pipe.
I think they've hit 4 or 5 pipes already.
Yeah, well they were hitting that crossbar a bunch in that first quarter.
Oh, good job by Louis, huh?
Yeah, that one deflected.
Rothfuss comes up with it. She's so two-handed.
And Rothfuss, nice give there to Reynolds.
She got a piece of that, Soskin.
This one will stay with Penfield. Rothfuss now. Oh, that shot.
Oh, it's Soskin came up with that.
Soskin all over that.
See, what a screen. I'd like to see a replay if we get a timeout on that. There was 3 or 4 girls in front of Soskin. I don't know how she saw that.
Yeah, she was certainly shielded there. But somehow able to get body on ball. But this is where Penfield, they've been able to really get a number of shots off. Whether it's getting those rebounds. Is that shot? Nice. Rothfuss eaten up by Soskin. Soskin having a day.
Yeah, she's all pumped up too. She's pumped up.
Yeah, you got to be fired up after a save like that.
Oh, yeah.
And she would love nothing more than for her teammates to come back down on the offensive end and tie up this game. So possession with Ryan Reynolds. And Cold Spring Harbor now gonna settle this one down. No, that's Bentley.
What a move.
Bentley ties the game at 6.
We gotta see that again. The inside roll on that one.
Textbook inside roll.
It's like we'll call this. This isn't even inside roll. This is a turnstile. Watch this. Change the name. The Bentley turnstile. Boom.
Oh, nice job there. That's just kind of lulling your defender to sleep and getting inside there and able to finish that one. And that's her third of the game. She's got half the Cold Spring Harbor Golds here so far.
Oh yeah, Bentley's having a day.
And just like that, we have a brand new ball game. And now a fight for the ground ball. And this one going back to Penfield. So coming up with possession there, Emma Alexander. Oh, but that one deflected by Reynolds, and she's got the takeaway.
Mid-course turnover, and they got a 3-on-1. Oh, keep your eyes open. Reynolds can go.
Reynolds a shot.
Go!
Lead! Ryan Reynolds putting Cold Spring Harbor in front 7-6.
That's where you saw that height was huge. Watch how she gets her hands up high, almost over the goalie stick.
Boom. Yeah, that's one of those things. You can't teach height.
Nope.
Either you have it or you don't, and nope. That's where you keep that ball up. And we're going to get a timeout from Penfield here as Cold Spring Harbor, they come up with 3 unanswered goals to start the third.
We're going to queue up one of the big plays of the second half, which kind of turned the tide. I don't know if it was Soskin's save that got the 3-goal run started, but here's Rothfuss coming. She gets a step on her defender, gets her hands up. Oh, that was the save where she kick saved it like she was the Devil Ranger game last night.
That is epic.
See that game last night, Els?
Oh, I think we saw more than just a game.
That was something. But that was like a hockey save. I think Soskin has a little hockey history. A little hockey history. I think they call it the Winter Club in this town. She's definitely got some hockey skills playing in the basement or something, or the driveway. But I would imagine Coach Castellan has given him a little talking to her. I see they're talking to her now and her enthusiasm, but they got a little spunk going there. Let's see. Let's see if Coach York from Penfield could turn the tide with his conversation with the girls.
Yeah, and I think that first possession out of any timeout is big. You want to have that after timeout execution, but it's going to, of course, start on the draw circle. But again, going back to Cold Spring Harbor, and again, haven't been winning the draws, but they had to still feel good about their situation. They were only down by 1-2 goals, so still very much within reach. And sure enough, they come out here with 3 straight to start the third quarter to take the lead back.
Yeah, they definitely have the momentum right now. We'll see if Penfield can get it back. Let's see who Cold Spring Harbor brings out there. Got the Mulata, Callahan.
So they got
Mulata,
Callahan, Reynolds, Bentley. Looks like she's going to take this draw here.
Yeah, they got a midi back. I think who's the Maggie Spear or Spielberger playing midfield? I guess they flip flop them sometimes because they got 5 back to take away. Both teams have 5 defenders back. Take away the transition.
So Bentley against Rothfuss. And that GB goes to Maggie Spear. She gets that up ahead to Amelia Bentley. So Cold Spring Harbor looking for more. Oh, and that pass sails high. Oh, and a nice fight there for the ground ball.
Timeout.
By Gianna Marino. So she keeps that possession alive, and Coach Castellan takes the timeout. So with this timeout for CSH, we'll take a quick break, and we'll come back shortly. All right, so back live here after that Cold Spring Harbor timeout. So a nice job there by Gianna Marino to save what could have been a turnover, saving that possession and Cold Spring getting the timeout. So now the ball will start with Ryan Reynolds as CSH looks to extend this run here and make it four unanswered. So Reynolds now going to give to Spear. Spear flips to Spielberger. Now that's Kelly Callahan with the rock. She gives to Bentley behind the cage, and CSH going to work this one around here. And now that's Reynolds. Ooh! And it looks like she's going to get a free position here.
We've talked about this many times on our telecasts. That's mm-hmm. why you need a play on in the girls' game, because they took it away. Ooh, and it went wide. Made the ball go white. Yep, stays white.
Yeah, that's a perfect example right there. If you let it play on, then that's a goal right there.
Yeah, and if it doesn't go in, you give them the free throw.
Right. So Amelia Bentley.
Ooh, that's a tough look.
Yeah, that pass a little bit forced there and winds up in the stick of Kara's hand. And now Penfield looking to take this one the other way. So that's Allison Wells now, number two, clearing up the field for Penfield. So now they'll settle things down and try to even up this game as we're inside of 5 minutes remaining here in the third quarter. So they get the ball to Rothfuss as she's covered by Rachel Louie.
It's a great acceleration.
Now Fordham now. Fordham now with the give to Reynolds. So now that's Peyton Rothfuss once again. Gives back to Reynolds. Oh, and that shot.
Not the pipe!
Once again, off the pipe. Man, the pipes. A goalie's best friend.
Yeah, Emma Alexander has an opportunity now to tie it up.
And she's going to give this one back out to Aaliyah Petrie. And now that's Petrie drawing the whistle.
Yeah, Saskinet had a save on that one.
Yep. So Petrie lined up for Penfield. And again, they're going to pull this one back out. Reynolds now being defended by Spear.
Yeah, 2-on-1.
Oh, and that pass behind as it was intended for Alexander. Nice ground ball there.
Huge.
By Maggie Spear. And she gets that one up ahead to Zoe Soskin.
Smart.
Yep, smart Soskin going to work it backwards to Spielberger.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy.
And that pass does get to Jenna Kessler. Kessler just fighting to keep possession, and she does. So now Cold Spring gonna wisely settle things down here. So 2:20 remaining in the third. And so far, after getting shut out in the second quarter, Cold Spring Harbor pitching a shutout here in the third.
Yeah, interesting. Interesting how it turns.
Yeah, certainly, as we talked about, a game of runs. Now Mulata gives to Reynolds. And Reynolds. Oh, that's going to be a charge.
Call for a charge.
Drawing the charge there, Riley Corcoran.
It's a big play. Big play with under two. A chance to tie it up now. Let's see Cold Springs ride. This girl can go. Watch this. This girl's got great foot speed. But they move the balls. They find the open player. Smart. Oh, good check by Mulata. Great check by Mulata.
Nice job there. And there to scoop it.
Oh, good.
Maggie Spear. Now
they got numbers. They got numbers. But look at Capozzi sprinting back into the hole. Great job by Penfield getting back.
So Sienna Koch, as she pulls this one back out, and Cold Spring Harbor will settle here. A minute remaining in the third.
I'd take the air out right now.
Yeah, so would I. And if they do score, remember that play by Liv Mulata.
I always say turnovers usually turn into goals.
So now approaching 30 seconds here in the quarter. On the look for Bentley. Tough look.
Ooh, they got bailed out on that.
Yeah, this one will stay with CSH.
Oh, I think the official bailed out CSH. Oh, Amelia. We're under 15. Take your time.
Bentley. Oh, that one goes high. Got 8 seconds.
They're giving it back to him. Oh, it's gonna burn out.
So that's going to do it for the third quarter. Cold Spring Harbor up 7-6. So we'll take a quick break and come back shortly with the start of the final quarter. Okay, so back live here for the start of the fourth quarter. And fasten your seatbelts, because this should be a good one. Cold Spring Harbor with the 7-6 lead as they shut out Penfield in that third quarter. And the opening draw goes to Rothfuss. So Penfield looking to tie up this game, as this truly has been a game of runs.
Interesting how Cold Spring Harbor got shut out in the second quarter and Penfield got shut out in the third quarter, right?
Yeah.
Oh, Rothfuss gets their hands. Ooh, check.
Oh, ball down.
Yeah, that's going to be a free throw.
Yeah, this one's going to stay with Rothfuss. So an early opportunity here in the fourth for Penfield. Rothfuss with a free position.
Ooh.
Oh, that one goes high. And ball down. But Penfield, they do keep possession.
How do you pronounce Reagan's last name? You think Sirsu? Sirsu?
I said Sirku, but...
Okay.
I could be...
We got to get phonetics. I'll get phonetics next time. I tell you, I would run Kaposi and Rothfuss as a two-man. She got
Rothfuss, it. That
shot. Oh! She's got all the arsenal. She's got like every move in the arsenal. I'd like to see those two together running a two-man. They both got great stick skills, great IQ.
So that's Kaposi now.
Oh, good look.
Oh, nice check there.
Who was that, 17?
Nice job there by Mackenzie McGraw.
She's had a couple good defensive plays and clears today.
And now it's Soskin going to look for an outlet. That's a big defensive stance there for Cold Spring Harbor.
Look at Reynolds' strides.
Yeah, Reynolds, she can just gallop up the field.
Two strides and she's up.
That's like, you know, Giannis Antetokounmpo,
he
can get up the court in like two steps.
Oh, Coke got her hands free.
Goal! For the goal! Her second of the game. And that gives Cold Spring Harbor an 8-6 lead.
I've noticed, if you watch the pull out, re-dodge. That's the one thing that they get, like the defender, just you get the defender to like relax, and then boom. Great job by Sienna. That's a big goal. Two goals are big in this game because the defense is tightening up.
Yeah, I was going to say, if you can get a two-goal lead here on either side, that two-goal lead, it almost feels like double.
Yeah, it does seem that way, doesn't it? Well, let's see what happens at the draw circle.
So back at the draw circle, Bentley against Rothfuss. Oh, and that one goes right into the stick of Ruby Spielberger. That's big. So the momentum with Cold Spring Harbor here in the early stages of the fourth quarter. That's Ryan Reynolds. Oh, Reynolds looking there for Coke, but Spear there for the ground ball. Now possession with Kelly Callahan as she works it back to Amelia Bentley at X. Oh, nice look.
Oh!
And looks like, let's see what the call is here.
Just missed it. Oh, they gave it back to him. What was that call? Someone put their stick in the crease to pick the ball up? Maybe a defender did?
Not 100% sure. On that shot, though, was Liv Malata.
Great look by Bentley on that.
Yeah. Great opportunity there. Just unable to cash in. So Spielberger now, as she gives back to Bentley.
Good matchup, Kaposi and Reynolds. Reynolds gets her hands free.
Goal! Reynolds! And Cold Spring Harbor extending that lead to 9-6 on the second of the game for Ryan Reynolds.
See, Kaposi's trying to take away her right, but she gets a step up field, gets her hands free. She's shooting from there. Bingo. Gives him a 9-6 lead, right?
Yeah, this is the largest lead of the game for Cold Spring Harbor.
Penn Mayfield's going to need the rock. I mean, we're looking at clockwise 7:45. They're definitely going to need a ball. They need some momentum back. Momentum's in Seahawk Village right now.
Yeah, this is a big draw here.
And Posey's got it.
So just what Penfield needed, winning that draw. And now they're going to look to try to cash in.
Good ride by Callahan, but get this step.
So Cold Spring Harbor, it's been a while here since they've let up a goal. Their defense has really stood up, especially in this second half. Gone almost a quarter and a half here without allowing a goal. And that's Rothfuss now. She's being swarmed.
Ooh, she's gonna get a free throw here, I think. What'd he do? He had his hand up.
Looks like.
I'm confused. This official had his hand up.
On this one.
What do you have his hand
back
up for?
Yeah, and it goes back to Cold Spring Harbor. As they say, Michelle Cole's closest to it. Now that's Ryan Reynolds. And so Reynolds, she draws the whistle here on the offensive side for CSH. So Reynolds now, a chance for her third. Oh, that one goes high. Ground ball goes to Bentley. As we're at the midway point here in the fourth quarter.
I would definitely take the air out a little bit right now. Get your feet.
Yeah, definitely want to be deliberate here if you're Cold Spring Harbor. I mean, you can just pass the ball around here if they're not going to play you aggressively.
Here they come. Good double.
Yeah, they
good
send double. A double to Spear as she gets to Reynolds.
You got to double and cover the adjacents. So you see how when they double, they're not covering the adjacents? You got to double, cover the adjacents, and leave the people furthest from the ball open. Good look.
Oh, nice look.
Goal.
Spear to Bentley.
Great look by Maggie. And Bentley just got her fourth of the day. Good ball movement. Stay nice and spread. I see one of the coaches on the side. I think that's Rory Moan, their basketball coaches with Danielle. And I think he's telling them, just stay spread. You'll open up lanes for yourself. Good coaching. Both teams very well coached. Quality lacrosse out here today.
Absolutely. Great. Great matchup here. Again, for both of these teams, a really, really good job by the coaches scheduling this non-leaguer.
We certainly appreciate it.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. We were saying earlier, if this could be an annual thing, that would be great.
I think one of the top teams in the state, Victor's coming down to play St. Anthony's on Saturday, so that should be another good one.
Yeah, that's right. Victor making the trip down to the island.
And Victor's won the states in the B's last year, beating Garden City. I'm sure Coach Ettinger is going to be watching that to see if he gets another opportunity and Victor up in the state finals.
Yeah, Victor winning the last two state championships, I believe.
That's correct. Oh, Soskin
with the save. And what a second half defensively for Cold Spring Harbor. So now as they look to clear, Mackenzie McGraw. And she works that across to Reynolds.
Perfect time now to do exactly what Coach just said. Pull it out.
Yep, be patient.
You're looking at four under four with a four-goal lead. So here comes Callahan. Oh, they got to check on
This one's going to be staying with Kelly Callahan.
I got to tell you something. I think I would pull this out.
I was thinking the same thing.
Were you really?
Yeah, I would. Up four with 333.
Yeah.
I mean, she's got a great position to try and score.
And she does. Nice play by Callahan, putting in, bouncing in the upper corner. Let's see the replay on that one.
So no harm there as she extends that Cold Spring Harbor lead to five.
Watch this bounce shot. Boom. Upper corner.
Yeah.
That's it. She's going to a program that's been in the playoffs the last couple of years. University of Chicago, besides being arguably one of the best academic schools in the country, they've built a program there where they're playing in the NCAA tournament every year. Kudos. They're getting some good Long Island kids.
They got a nice campus, too. Very, very nice.
Yeah, it's a beautiful school. Chicago's a great city.
Oh, yeah.
So they're winning the draws. They're just not finishing in the second half. Oh, Malata, love the aggressiveness.
That is one tough customer right there, Liv Malata. And for Penfield, Allison Wells. They're checking on her, number two, to make sure that she's okay.
Stop the clock at 3:12.
Looks like Wells, she's going to check out of the game here. They'll make sure that she's okay. So now inside of 3 minutes remaining in what's been a second half that's been really dominated by Cold Spring Harbor. So Penfield, they do get the shooting space there, does Whitney Reynolds. Reynolds.
Goal!
That's a goal for Whitney Reynolds.
She stung it. Let's get a replay on that. Through the five hole, I believe, right?
As we take another look here on our Total Coach instant replay. Reynolds locked and loaded. Yeah, I think you might be right. Through the wickets there.
Different angle here. I like the many angles we're getting from the Long Island Sports Network. We're going to go to the draw, but boom. Yeah, I think that went right between the wickets. And here's the draw. Big GB for Bentley. This is when you use the clock, Coach.
Yup, absolutely. Got to be disciplined here.
Up four?
Yup, definitely want to take the air out of this one.
Yeah, you're going to see Coach Castellon watch anybody getting in trouble use her last time out if she needs it. Yeah, see, they're spreading. You see how the fields are now? They're going to go double. They don't want to back her here. You don't need a backer here. You just need to double and block off the adjacents. See, early in the season, you don't get to work on a lot of this stuff, so unfortunately, then it's probably the package isn't in yet. But you need to get that in. Got some parents yelling in the background, you hear?
So Spear gives to Spielberger. Now to Reynolds.
You're at a minute. We're getting to a minute 30. Capozzi's chasing. They have to cover the adjacents. So they have to get on the adjacents. Cold Spring right now is moving the ball too fast, which is a good idea on their part.
So Callahan, again, just going to take time.
You got to pop out and you got to get, don't get tired. Now we're down to almost a minute. We're at about a minute three. This is the one part which, when we have the shot clock, will not be happening unless it's below 80 seconds.
Right. Shot clock coming in next year.
Yep. It's already in Maryland. Sacred Heart was down there playing, and I saw that they were using it. So I think that's important. You're down to 40 seconds.
So Reynolds just going to run away and protect here. Now gives to Mulata. And this is a good win for Cold Spring Harbor.
Oh, yeah, especially when they were down early.
Yeah, down by three early on. But Maya Soskin coming up with a number of big saves to keep them in it. And the offense just took off here in the second half and only allowed one goal.
And we'll be heading down to the field to pick the LALJ player of the games. No goal. The goal did not count. Shouldn't have shot that.
But that'll do it. An 11-7 win for CSH. They are now 3-0 on the season. Just want to thank everyone that tuned into the broadcast. Great win for CSH. Great job by Penfield coming down here, making the trip. They'll be playing Northport tomorrow. But thanks to everyone that tuned in. And we'll talk to you on the other side.
Have a good night.